to binary numbers, if you look at day-to-day numbers which we have those numbers in base 10. So we talk about numbers like, let's suppose, 256.79, let's suppose. We are using digits from 0 through 9, so we're using digits from 0 through 9 in the base 10 system, and that's why it's called the base 10 system, because there are 10 digits going from 0 to 9, because you're including 0, so up to 9 makes it 10 digits. So if you look at this number here, each of these numbers you're seeing, 2, 5, 6, 7, and 9, have a place in the number itself. So for example, if you look at 2, 2 stands for 200, 5 stands for 50, and 6 is your single digit there, and 7 is 1/10 multiplied by 7. This one is 1/100 of whatever that place number is. So if I was going to write this, I would write this like this: 2 times 10 to the power 2, plus 5 times 10 to the power 1, plus 6 times 10 to the power 0. So that would be the number of 256. So you're seeing that the 2 has is part of hundreds, 5 is part of tens, and 6 is part of 10 to the power 0. And then if you look at the number which is after the decimal point, you get 7 times 10 to the power minus 1, plus 9 times 10 to the power minus 2. So each number has a place, and if you're looking at the base 10 number or your decimal numbers, they use digits of 0 through 9. Now in binary numbers, it's very similar. So when you're looking at binary numbers, some people get scared about binary numbers because it's different. And that's true, it is different, but no need to be scared about it. The thing is that binary numbers is base 2. It's base 2, so you're only going to use 2 digits as opposed to using 10 digits in your base 10. And the numbers which you use in the binary is 0 and 1. That's it. And the reason why we use only 0 and 1, because if you understood about the bits in a computer or in a computer memory, that can be on or off. So off might be 0, on might be 1. So you can only represent 0 and 1 in your binary notation in a computer. So that's why we use base 2. So we have base 2. We have two numbers which you can represent, 0 and 1. So let's go and look at a number in binary notation and see that what it is equivalent to in the base 10 notation, so that you can go back and forth between the two numbers. So let's suppose somebody gives me a number like this, says, hey, I'm going to give you a number like 1011.0011 base 2. Now, this dot which you're seeing here is no longer called the decimal point. The reason why it's not called decimal point is because it is now in the base 2. The common name which is given to it is the radix point. So if you are dealing with base 2, base 4, base 8, base 16, base 10, you can always call this point to be the radix point. So that differentiates between the integer part and the fractional part of a number. Now, if I was going to look at what is the equivalent of this binary number, what I would do is I will see what the placement is. Now here, just like in your decimal notation, the placement for this number 1 was 10 to the power 0. Here it will be just 2 to the power 0. Here it will be 2 to the power 1. Here it will be 2 to the power 2. Here will be 2 to the power 3. So that's the only thing which has changed so far as the base is concerned. So you have the base of 2 now as opposed to 10. This will be 2 to the power minus 1. This one will be 2 to the power minus 2. This one will be 2 to the power minus 3. And this number here will be 2 to the power minus 4. So you can see how the placements are very similar to the way you have into decimal numbers. So there's not much difference between the two. So let me write this number again, because I wrote a lot at the above notation, so I'm going to just rewrite the same number. So you have 1011, radix point 00112. And 2 stands, this number here, 2, which you have here, is for the base which you are using for the numbers. So now what I'm going to do is I'm going to get this 1, which will be 2 to the power 3, that is this number here, then plus 0 times 2 to the power 2, that is this number here, then plus 1 times 2 to the power 1, that is this number here, plus 1 times 2 to the power 0, and it's the last number before the radix point. Now, taking care of the the numbers which are after the radix point, I got 0 times 2 to the power minus 1, that takes care of this number, plus 0 times 2 to the power minus 2, takes care of that number, plus 1 times 2 to the power minus 3, which takes care of that number, plus 1 times 2 to the power minus 4, and takes care of that number. And if you go ahead and calculate this number, you're going to get 11.1875. And this number is the equal number in the base 10. So what I've shown to you in this segment is how to convert or how to see what the equivalent of the base 2 number which is given to you to what is the base 10. In the next segment, I'll show you how to do the reverse process where somebody gives you a number in the decimal or base 10 notation. How do you convert it into a binary number? And that's the end of this segment.